letters till the sun went down, and he tried to be brave and sign off saying, I love you, Mum, more than anyone. At the front line, fear in his eyes, he held his gun. He didn't want to be like all his friends, now dead and gone. He turned around and walked away, put down his gun. Deserter, coward and cause for shame, they called my son. And I'm proud that in the midst of war, you had the strength to say no more. And if I could see you one more time, I'd hold your face and smile and say, I love you, son, more than anyone. I love you, son.
At the trial, there were two very different versions of how Harry Farr was arrested. The first witness for the prosecution, the regimental sergeant major, said he told Farr to go up to the trenches, Farr refused, and then the sergeant major said, I again warned him that he would have to go to the trenches or be tried for cowardice. But in Harry Farr's account of this, what the sergeant major said, and I quote, is, you are a fucking coward and you will go to the trenches. I give fuck all for my life and I give fuck all for yours, and I'll get you fucking well shot. The second has the desperate ring of truth. After a short trial, Harry Farr was sentenced to death. No provision was made for his disturbed mental state.